This is an experimental project, and I made this project to get raw data for audio and images from a USB camera on ESP32-S3. To transmit images and audio simultaneously via Wi-Fi, you can use a protocol like RTSP. It's difficult to use this in a real project, but I wanted to try this kind of project. You can find out which formats are supported by looking at the USB device's descriptor. I used the USB descriptor dumper program for Windows, and it was easy to figure it out. Through this, you can check the MJPEG format and support resolution as well as the microphone channels and bit resolution. This is a hardware configuration. I'm using ESP32-S3 DevKit C1 and the USB breakout board is connected to GPIO 19 and 20. With this, you can easily make a USB female port, and here I use an adapter to change it back to USB A type. Next time, I should buy a USB breakout board with a USB-C port type. It seems much more useful. Anyway, connect the USB camera here. This completes the connection between the ESP32 and the USB camera. Next, the most important thing for this project is probably the use of a USB camera. I use the Logitech C270 for this project. This is one of the USB cameras that works very well for UVC projects. If you have issues with USB cameras, try this one. It works the best as far as I know. One of the examples in ESP IoT solution provides an example of capturing video and audio data from a USB camera at the same time. After capturing the audio data, it's rewritten to the connected speaker and the image data is transmitted via HTTP. The ESP32 operates in Wi-Fi AP mode and can be accessed via Wi-Fi. Unfortunately, this example project does not transmit the audio data via HTTP together. For your information, I tried this project on IDF version 5.3. Anyway, let's clone this entire project and try this example project. I opened this example project in VS Code. I set up the target device and the serial port. Let's just go through the necessary settings briefly. The ESP32-S3 DevKit C1 I have has 8 MB flash memory. Next, if you need to send data via HTTP in this project, the size of the program will increase, so I changed the partition table. Oh, PSRAM. This device has 8 MB octal PSRAM. It operates in Wi-Fi AP mode. The AP name is ESP32-S3-UVC and you can check the connection IP. Depending on the USB device, the descriptor may have different data sizes. In the case of this Logitech C270, the descriptor size is more than 1024 bytes, so I doubled it. Back to the main, I need to switch on to transfer a UVC frame to Wi-Fi HTTP. Okay, all looks good. Let's build and test the UVC. After connecting to ESP32-S3 UVC via Wi-Fi or mobile, I access it via web browser. Up to this point, it's the same as what I tried in my previous UVC project. It transmits 15 fps without any issues at VGA resolution. If the speaker is connected, you can hear the audio data input from the microphone being output through the speaker. However, I wanted to test transmitting not only images but also audio data via Wi-Fi connection, so I prepared one more test. Alright, let's see this one together. The role of this WebSocket server is simply to transmit each audio and image data transmitted from ESP32 to other clients. ESP32 transmits the captured image data through UVC callback and transmits the audio data captured from the microphone through UAC callback, sending image and audio data simultaneously through WebSocket is not a good idea. You can transmit these data more easily using the RTSP protocol. Please use the RTSP protocol to make it like an IP camera if you need it. This is a test to receive raw data of image or audio coming from a USB camera. My ESP32 is connected to the WebSocket server and you can access it via your web browser. You will see a few buttons and checkboxes on a simple screen. After connecting, you can select the data you want to view or listen to. Let's first receive the image data. Unlike the previous demo project, there is a delay of about 1 second. In fact, this is a cue intended to synchronize audio and image. However, as mentioned, the WebSocket method is not suitable for real streaming for multimedia, so this is also one of the unnecessary functions. Anyway, there is a delay of 1 second, but the image is still transmitted without any problem. This time, let's listen to the audio data. Let's turn off the image data and turn on the audio.
My voice is now being transmitted.
Sorry, my MacBook and microphone were too close. 1 second, please.
My voice is now being transmitted from the USB camera to the node server and then played through the speakers of my MacBook. Currently, only voice is being transmitted and it works very smoothly. Using the built-in microphone of USB camera can be very helpful for many projects. However, there's a lot of work that needs to be done to transmit audio and images together, so I recommend using a protocol like RTSP.
The audio quality is good. I think it's good enough to use in some projects. What happens if you send image and audio data to WebSocket at the same time from ESP32? Each time the callback function is called, the send function of the WebSocket is called. And if the previous task has not finished, it must wait. This causes an issue in the USB streaming because the next data comes while the buffer is not empty yet. That is why it is useful to send it as a set of data rather than sending it separately to the WebSocket. This seems to be another challenge. If I have an update, I will share it with you again. Alright, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.